Hello everybody, crazy Russian dude here, and I'm not political, but I did watch the debates of the Democrats. As a Russian immigrant in this country, I always find it interesting to see what the local politicians have to say. They all agree that Donald Trump is completely evil. On the scale of evilness, there is like a Satan, then there is maybe like a cohort of Hitler, Lenin, Stalin, Mao Zedong, and then there is Donald Trump. And not necessarily in this order. I think by now they would probably say that Donald Trump is more evil than Satan. In fact, if they had asked those candidates, like, if we were to give you a gun, would you shoot Donald Trump right now? All of them would say, absolutely, give me the gun and I will shoot him repeatedly, you know, all those body parts. Which I think is weird, because whatever you think about Republicans and Donald Trump, he is a sitting president. There is so much, you know, to fix in the country, and they should not be so fixated on Donald Trump. It has become like a war on Trump and war on cancer and war on drugs and all of this. And next, Elizabeth Warren with her mandatory taxing of the billionaires. And I will tell you, I do understand where she is coming from, because billionaires have the money. It's kind of like, who was this, Dillinger or some other gangster, when they were asked, why do you rob banks? Supposedly they said, because that's where they keep the money. So same here, billionaires do have a lot of money, and therefore they're an easy target. On the other hand, I thought in this country they already have this progressive taxing or something like this, right? So the more money you make, the higher tax bracket you end up with. And I know, because I do my own taxes, and when I take this number 93A and plug it in, you know, they tell me, if it's under $50,000, you pay, 20%, and then you pay 25%. Eventually, when you get to a billion, I guess, I never looked, you pay, 40%. So I am just a dumb Russian immigrant, but it would seem to me that billionaires already pay more taxes than everybody else, both as percentage as well as in absolute numbers. And my suggestion is to introduce voluntary tax. Hold on, bad intersection. Okay, I'm safe. Voluntary tax, which basically means if you want to give more money, you know, to various good causes, then, you know, check this box and plug in the number. I bet a lot of people would actually do this, and I think that's right, because the government should not just, like, take the money from, you know, one pocket to put into the other, okay? It's not their money. Elizabeth Warren, it's not your money, it's not government's money, it's that billionaire's money, or that millionaire's money, or that middle-class person's money. Next, they talked about pharmaceutical companies and how those executives need to, like, rot in jail and all of this. I find it strange, because I once worked for a technical company that served, you know, the big pharma. And I actually know something about that pharmaceutical industry. And I agree, the industry is far from perfect and is corrupt and all of this. But at the same time, it's a very tough industry. It's a very important industry. I don't know if you knew, but it takes about 12 to 13 years to actually bring the drug to market. And it costs $1.5 billion, probably more by now, to actually bring the drug to market. And then they only have like a year or two before the patent runs out to actually make their money. So this is not a walk in the park. It's actually very tough business. And I believe pharmaceutical company actually contributes a lot. They give a lot of money for people who cannot afford the drugs and all of this. But they're picking on those executives as if they were Darth Vaders of some kind. I personally believe those executives are like any other executives. Some are good and some are not so good, and some are somewhere in the middle. But to say that those guys are like completely evil, they need to go to jail, they need to like burn at the stake, like that fervor is just completely crazy. That's the kind of fervor that like sent Joan of Arc, you know, to her death. No, I'm not comparing pharma executives to Joan of Arc. I'm just saying, like, that type of a crazy religious fervor is just not right. It's just not balanced. And speaking of not balanced, to me, Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders seem, how do I best put it? They seem insane. They seem like they just stepped out of like a Russian revolution. No, seriously, like the only difference between them and like Leon Trotsky and all of those other people who call for the political revolution is that instead of speaking Russian, they actually speaking English, and they live like 100 years after Leon Trotsky. By the way, I totally agree, we do need some social programs in this country, you know, for the greater good and all of this. But the passion, the fervor, the fanaticism with which Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren talk about taking money from the rich and giving them to the poor, you know, like Lenin and Stalin and Trotsky and all of those people would have been proud. All in all, out of that lineup of candidates, I would pick three people, you know, to become a president. Maybe they can rule as this triumvirate. I would put Joseph Biden there, okay, because he seems sane and he seems like a real politician, and he at least once asked his fellow Democrats, well, how are we going to pay for all of this? Which suggests to me that he's actually like paying attention, you know, to the fiscal side of the house. Then I would pick Mr. Yang. Mr. Yang seems incredibly bright and a very original thinker, and he said the word AI, artificial intelligence, at least a couple of times, which suggests to me that he knows that this is year 2019 and not like, I don't know, 1989. And then I would also pick this lady from Hawaii with like a gray streak of hair. She's an army veteran or something, like I can't remember her name, but she too seemed very bright, very balanced, you know, very reasonable and very much an original thinker. So yes, if possible, Democrats should nominate those three people to be one president. I think this would be really nice. Anyway, I didn't want to make a political video, but something tells me that maybe this video is just like slightly tiny bit political. But weather is nice, foliage here in New England, and you should go outside and breathe some fresh air. I am Crazy Russian Dad, and I approve this message. Good night.